This week on Stakelbeck on Terror, rockets, suicide bombings, and agriculture, we reveal the new Arab plan to take away Israel's God-given land without firing a shot.
They're taking the land piece by piece, and there are no tanks in this war. It's tractors, it's bulldozers.
Plus, we get on the ground in Israel's biblical heartland of Judea to investigate how Palestinians are trying to seize Israeli land one tree at a time.
They have started a new kind of war against us. It's called the agricultural jihad.
And then we get up close to give you the truth about those so-called Israeli settlements that the Obama administration and the world are pressuring Israel to dismantle. All that and much more from Israel. Let's go to work. Welcome to Stakelbeck on Terror. You know, every week on this show, we aim to bring you the truth, all of it, with no consideration over hurt feelings or political correctness. Now, I care what my family thinks, I care what my employer thinks, and most of all, I care what God thinks. But that's it. This is no time to mince words, folks. This is a time to be bold and to speak truth to power. To be watchmen and women on the wall. Time is short. And for some reason, God has seen fit to give me a platform here with this show. And I am going to leave all of the consequences to Him while I use this show to educate, to sound the alarm, and to call evil for what it is. And let me tell you, it doesn't get more evil or more anti-God than the campaign to erase Israel, God's land and God's people, from the map. As you'll see on today's show, there are many different ways that Israel's enemies are attempting to do just that. And some of their tactics don't involve their usual weapons of choice, guns, bombs, and rockets. I recently spent time on the ground in Judea, in Israel's biblical heartland, which the world calls the West Bank. While I was there, I visited the beautiful Israeli town of Gush Etzion, just south of Jerusalem. I was there on a Friday afternoon, just before the beginning of Shabbat, and there was an energy and excitement on the streets as people were scrambling around to make last-minute preparations for Shabbat dinner with their families. Now, the UN and the Obama administration would like you to believe that these so-called settlements are filled with wild-eyed, violent fanatics. That is a massive lie, ladies and gentlemen. I've spent time throughout Judea and Samaria, the so-called illegal settlements. These are beautiful, thriving, close-knit communities filled with religious and secular families. I always say they remind me of the suburbs of Arizona or Southern California. Great weather, clean air, what a place to raise a family. And most importantly, this is the biblical heartland, where most of the stories in the Old Testament of your Bible took place. Before King David established his throne in the eternal city of Jerusalem, Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Joseph all lived and worked here. So, the good people of Gush Etzion decided to plant some trees and beautify an area of their town called Netzer. This is land that the state of Israel owns legally. But that hasn't stopped local Palestinians, supported by their left-wing allies, from uprooting and destroying the trees of Netzer. Israelis plant trees, and the Arabs come, oftentimes under the cover of night, and destroy them out of pure, childish spite, and because they covet Israel's land. This happens time and time again. We spoke to the mayor of Gush Etzion, Davidi Perel, about it.
We are, as the people that live here, want to keep the pieces of land, to extend the communities, to have agriculture, like trees and stuff. But the Arabs want too, so they're trying to fight through the land. They're trying to take out the trees. They don't want to put another trees in other pieces of land.
You know, when you think about it, this is really a metaphor for the larger struggle for Israel's existence. Israel builds, the Muslim Arabs destroy. Here's more from Mayor Perel.
But if you go a bit out of the center of the Gush Etzion, in a way to Hebron, in a way to Bethlehem, it's a big problem. Because these Arabs live under the Palestinian government, let's say, and they have the feeling that they have to fight with us, and they go out to the roads, throwing stones, firebombs, and all this stuff.
Now, again, Netzer and what's going on there is part of the larger overall war against the Jewish people and the land of Israel. Israel's enemies know they can't win a conventional war, so they are going to chip away incrementally, bit by bit. They're very patient, and they're very diabolical, and they have the backing of the world community. It's to the point that a Jew planting a tree in Netzer, on Israeli land, is becoming an international incident that causes an uproar at the UN. Even though Jews lived in Gush Etzion thousands of years ago. Listen to Nadia Matar. She's the founder of a great group called Women in Green.
The Arabs want to expel the Jews from their land, from our God-given lands, whether it's in Judea and Samaria, in the Negev, Galilee, or anywhere. And here, what their way of dealing with it is funded by billions of dollars of the European Union and other anti-Israeli NGOs. For the past 6, 7, 8 years, they have started a new kind of war against us. It's called the agricultural jihad. All of a sudden, they've been funded so well that they go up with tractors, fancy tractors all over, and steal our land, our state land.
And folks, it's not just happening in Netzer. I recently sat down with Ari Briggs. He's the spokesman for a very important organization called Regavim that is dedicated to preserving and protecting Israel's national lands. He told us about the silent war against Israel that you haven't heard about. It's a story no one else is covering, but we're bringing it to you exclusively on Stakelbeck on Terror. Take a look. Well, Ari, welcome.
Hey, Eric.
Great to have you here. Yeah, last time I saw you, we were in Samaria on the mountains of Israel.
Correct.
So it's great to have you here in Washington, D.C., sounding the alarm. You know, when we talk about Israel and we talk about so-called land disputes, the international community, including the Obama administration, mm-hmm. loves to zero in on supposed illegal housing in Judea, Samaria, Israel's biblical heartland. But your organization is doing great work highlighting another land dispute that is a real security threat to Israel. Tell us what's going on in the Negev region.
Okay, so it's, you know, the Negev is a great example for what's going on. There's this silent conquest of the land of Israel, and the idea is that the Arabs have realized they can't beat us with war, they can't beat us with tanks, with missiles, even with suicide bombers. So what they're doing is they're taking the land piece by piece, and there are no tanks in this war. It's tractors, it's bulldozers, and they're coming in and they're taking this land, and the government's not doing anything about it.
The Israeli government.
The Israeli government for years hasn't been doing anything about it. So Regavim's role is, we've got researchers in the field, we've got informers, they let us know what's going on, and we bring that to the attention of the authorities. And so we've got a great legal team that's writing letters to the authorities, and when nothing happens, we go to court. And the idea is to embarrass. We also go public. We have exposés on the news, because without going public, without this public campaign to embarrass the government to look after our own land, nothing's going to change. This is way away from Tel Aviv. This is down in the south. No one knows what's going on.
Yeah, there. I was going to ask you just if you could just fill us in more where the Negev is, okay. The size of the Negev, kind
for
of
sure.
Demographics
yeah.
there.
No, for sure. So the Negev's in 2/3. Of Israel is actually the Negev, and it's in the south of the country. It's, you know, this whole greening of the desert, that's where that's happening, is in the Negev. But most of the Negev is desert. There are a lot of army bases, firing zones down there, so it takes up most of the Negev. So what we're talking about here is the northern Negev, around Be'er Sheva, which is obviously
which is a large city.
Large city, 200,000 residents in Be'er Sheva. That's around 10,000 acres. Now, what you have right next to Be'er Sheva, actually in between Be'er Sheva, Arad, and Dimona, it's like a triangle there, is 90,000 Bedouins who have just gone and taken whatever land, just settled down on whatever land they feel like settling on. 90,000 of them.
Now, just so people know, the Bedouins are kind of roving Arab tribes.
So, yeah, they left the Saudi Arabia, Hejaz area, in the late 1700s, early 1800s, and they moved all over the Middle East. Now, some of them came to the Sinai, some of them came to the Negev, and they were nomadic.
They're nomadic. Ari, they're not indigenous to the land of Israel.
Well, that's not what the UN says. You know, there are Bedouin all over the Middle East. Mm-hmm. And the only place the UN has classed them as indigenous is to southern Israel, to the Negev. The only place, they're in the Sinai. We hear about them in Jordan. We hear about them in Lebanon, Syria, Iraq, Iran. But the only place the UN says they're indigenous is southern Israel. And they've changed their terminology as well. They used to be called Israeli Bedouins. Now they're called Palestinian Bedouins, citizens of Israel.
Now so the UN is pushing that.
The UN is pushing that. Well, obviously there are a lot of NGOs that are pro-Bedouin, anti-Israel, and they're pushing this as another way to attack Israel. You know, they already feel they've taken Judea and Samaria away from us. They already feel they can taste that Palestinian state's about to be established. And now they're going after the Negev, the northern Negev. And it's just south of Judea.
Ari, we have to go to commercial real quick. Ladies and gentlemen, this is such an important story. You're not hearing anywhere else. The work Regavim International is doing, so important. This land jihad going on. You're not hearing in the mainstream media. You'll hear it here. Much more with Ari Briggs coming up. Stay tuned.
Remember to check out the Stakelbeck on Terror blog at cbnnews.com 24/7 for the latest on these and other stories. Do you want to know the truth about the jihadist in your backyard? Then be sure to pick up my book, The Terrorist Next Door, How the Government is Deceiving You About the Islamist Threat. Available wherever books are sold from coast to coast.
Today we're on a field trip to discover what inflation is doing to our paper money. In this hand is a $20 bill, and in this hand is a $20 U.S. gold coin. They used to have the same buying power, but how much can they buy today? In this first basket is what my $20 bill buys: milk, bread, peanut butter, and jelly. And here's what one $20 gold coin will buy: 6 baskets full, worth nearly $2,000, almost 100 times more food, simply by owning gold dollars instead of paper dollars. History shows that the gold coins have been the best way to beat the rising cost of living. So class, the moral is that unless you want to live on peanut butter and jelly sandwiches in the future, you should turn some paper dollars into gold coins now. How and why is explained in a new book, The Great Debasement. Call the number below for a totally free copy. And that's the simple truth.
If an emergency happened right now, you can have help at the push of a button with Medical Alert.
Remember when I took that fall, Mary?
Oh, yes, that was terrible.
Yes, it was.
Help!
And I thought, what if you hadn't been there? I ordered my Medical Alert the next day.
I can't describe how safe I feel now with my Medical Alert. You didn't know I was wearing it, did you?
Medical Alert is easy to install, waterproof, and covers you inside your home and out.
It helps me feel safe from fires, break-ins.
And of course, a Medical Alert. And if you don't have a home phone, don't worry. They have that covered.
There's always help at the push of a button. Don't wait till you need it.
Get Medical Alert for less than $1 a day. There are no long-term contracts. Order now and get your second button free. Call for your free brochure.
For your free Medical Alert system with second button free, call 800-575-8507.
And welcome back. We're talking to Ari Briggs of Regavim International, great group. Ari, you're describing something for us that a lot of people don't know about. This literal land grab of portions of southern Israel. Two-thirds of Israel is the Negev Desert, as you said. Talk about the security threat that this poses. God knows Israel has enough security threats on its borders. This is a developing security threat within its borders, mm-hmm. It seems.
No, for sure. So this is a silent conquest. No one hears about it. And what happens, especially in the Negev, but all over the country, with the Bedouin, they have their sister tribes. The same tribes are over in the Sinai. And from Gaza into Israel, there's a great fence. Nothing is getting through there, except obviously when they fire rockets over. But they can't smuggle weaponry in and try and get it to the forces, their terrorist forces within Israel. But what they can do is smuggle it out to Sinai, and then around the Sinai back into Israel through the Negev. The border there was caught based on milestones, which literally is a stone every mile. Now, Israel recently built a fence, a great fence to try and, you know, a necessary fence on a border to stop the African immigration that was
That's
happening.
That's another issue. Tel Aviv having big problems with
Correct.
Those African
so it was
migrants,
all coming
illegal.
In, it was the Bedouins who were getting all the money in the Sinai and also in the Negev to transfer these guys across the border.
Well, let's talk about the Bedouins a little bit, because you're talking, Ari, about the smuggling issue with them, but there's other issues. We're not trying to tar all Bedouins, but look, there's some serious issues with the Bedouin population when it comes to women's rights, polygamy, right?
Well, they have on average 3 to 4 wives, on average 20 to 30 kids, the highest growth rate in the world, 5.6%. It means they double their population every 15 years. Now, polygamy is illegal in Israel, but it's allowed to exist in their communities because Israel respects their Sharia law, which allows them to have multiple wives. But in any population, you've got 50% men, 50% women. So they need to import women as well. And these women don't have Israeli citizenship as the Bedouins do in Israel. So their husbands lock them up in their house. They can't leave their house. When they need to go and have a baby, they get given the Israeli ID card of the one Israeli wife. They go to the hospital, give birth. They start, you know, the kids obviously get all the benefits of being an Israeli citizen. The wife then comes back home and is locked up again. It's very difficult. The Bedouin men, you know, it's a cultural thing.
Culture.
I don't want to paint the whole culture, but this is what we
it's
see
an issue.
Happening.
Talk about the overseas funding real quick that's going in to undermine Israel
we
as well.
We understand in most mosques here in the United States, in Europe for sure, they're collecting money for this land grab. They understand the importance of taking over the land of Israel. They couldn't do it with tanks. They couldn't do it with missiles. Now they're doing it with good money. Also coming in, of course, from Qatar, from Bahrain, from the UAE, from Saudi Arabia.
The Gulf states,
going in, paying this Islamic branch to go and create as many. Again, what are we talking about here? It's facts on the ground. That's what they're doing day in, day out. Fridays, Saturdays, when the inspectors aren't working, they're in building, taking more and more land, putting up more and more fences.
Tell us where we can find more about Regavim and what we can do to help.
For sure. So we've got a website, www.regavim.org.il/en for English, but you can go to the Hebrew English website. And of course, Facebook, Regavim, which daily updates about what's really happening in the field by our researchers, by ourselves. And again, we are up against not only all this money coming from the Muslim Brotherhood, but from NGOs all over the world. There are 50 or plus NGOs working to take the Negev away from us and give it to the Bedouin. And here's Regavim trying to stand up against them. We're a small organization, so anything people can do to help, that would
Excellent.
Be appreciated.
Excellent. Well, we're with you, Ari. Thank you so much, my friend. God bless you and the work you're doing.
Thank you,
Keep
Eric.
It up, my friend.
Thank
yeah.
you very much.
Much more coming up. Stay tuned.
Attention, sleep apnea patients. Are you tired of the expense and hassle of getting your CPAP and BiPAP supplies? Are you fed up with dealing with ill-fitting, leaking, or worn-out masks and straps? Are you worried about the effects that unsanitary tubes, cushions, and filters have on your health? If you said yes to any of these questions, Allied Medical Supply Network has the solution to your problems. You could qualify to have your supplies regularly delivered right to your door at little or no cost to you. That's right, no more inconvenience, no worn-out masks and straps, no more unsanitary equipment, just restful sleep. Call Allied Medical Supply Network today to determine if you may qualify to receive your fresh, brand-name supplies at little or no cost. Don't delay. Call us now to see if you are eligible to save money on regular delivery of your CPAP and BiPAP supplies. Call 1-800-815-9947. That's 1-800-815-9947. Or go to CPAPSupplyHelpline.com.
Announcing an important breakthrough in healthcare that can benefit everyone. If you or anyone you love needs affordable health insurance, regardless of a pre-existing medical condition, call Quick Insurance 123 today and get the immediate relief you deserve. Quick Insurance 123 was created to provide affordable health insurance to all uninsured Americans, with or without pre-existing conditions. This is not a discount card. This is a real insurance program that lets you choose from many affordable health plans, with access to doctors, hospitals, emergency services, and more. So call the number on your screen now and get the health coverage you need, just for calling. As a special bonus, we'll send you a free prescription savings card that could save you up to 85% on your prescriptions. That's right, you could save up to 85% on your prescriptions, just for calling. Call Quick Insurance 123 to find out how you can get affordable health insurance and receive your free prescription savings card, just for calling. Don't wait. Getting a free quote is as easy as 123. Call today.
And welcome back. Well, the world calls it the West Bank, but the 350,000 plus Israelis who live there call the region by its biblical name, Judea and Samaria. These so-called settlers have been branded the main obstacle to Middle East peace: religious extremists, illegal occupiers, and worse. Don't believe it. The areas where they live play a crucial part in Israel's security and biblical heritage. I've been blessed to spend a lot of time there, and here's some of what I found.
500,000 Israelis uprooted from their homes. According to a recent UN report, international law demands such a move. The report called for Israel to evacuate all existing settlements and dismantle Jewish communities in the eastern half of Jerusalem. The UN considers all these neighborhoods illegal settlements that will one day be included in a Palestinian state. Global pressure to hand this territory over to the Palestinians mounts against Israel by the day, including tough words from the Obama administration. Yet on a recent tour of Judea and Samaria, CBN News found a much different picture than what is often portrayed in the media and world forums.
The population is growing. We're growing five times greater than the national average in Israel.
David Haivri is spokesman for the Shamron Regional Council in Samaria. He says a growing number of Israelis are relocating to the area for the same reasons Americans move from the city to the suburbs: family-friendly communities, fresh air, and land at affordable prices.
Young families who wish to establish themselves and raise children look around and they say, where are our kids going to get a good standard of living? It's a beautiful scenery. We're up here on the mountain. We have great weather. It's cool in the summer. The prophets promised that the children of Israel would return to these mountains and rebuild these Jewish cities and Jewish towns, and that's what's happening.
While Haivri, like many here, is an observant Jew, 60% of those living in Samaria are secular. Ariel University is the region's educational hub, and its 16,000 students come from all over Israel. Arab students here are free to wear Muslim religious attire, and they study alongside Jews. We found a similar story at the nearby Barkan Industrial Park, home to some 150 businesses where Israelis work side by side with their Palestinian neighbors.
An Arab working in these businesses, in these factories, makes double or three times as much in some cases as he would make working for the Palestinian Authority in the Palestinian areas, and the ability to move up the ladder into a supervisory or a management position.
But life here is not without its challenges. The Jewish communities of Samaria are frequent targets for Palestinian terror attacks. The 2011 massacre of Udi and Ruth Fogel and three of their small children in the Samarian town of Itamar was one horrific example. They were murdered in their sleep by two local Palestinians. Further south, in the Judean city of Hebron, the situation is also difficult.
During the Second Intifada, we were shot at for 2.5 years here. There are still terrorist attacks here.
David Wilder is the spokesman for Hebron's small Jewish community. The city, which is mostly Palestinian Arab, is home to Judaism's second holiest site, the Cave of the Patriarchs.
This is the Cave of the Patriarchs in Hebron. Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Rebekah, Sarah, Leah, the patriarchs, the matriarchs of the land of Israel, of the Bible, they're all buried here.
You cannot let terrorism determine how you live and where you live. If you know that this is your home and this is where you're supposed to be, what would be more normal for a Jew to live in the city of Hebron?
In withdrawing from Judea and Samaria, Israel would not only be giving up a huge part of its past, it could be harming its future.
God forbid Palestinian terrorists, Hamas terrorists would be standing here. They would be basically in total control. And they won't need the long-range missiles. They could reach basically to every town and city in this area.
Yuli Edelstein is a member of Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu's cabinet. He lives not far from Jerusalem in the Judean town of Gush Etzion, another area the UN once cleared of Jews.
Without our total control here in these areas, I think we won't be able even to run a normal country here.
Edelstein told CBN that some of the same forces that oppose Israel's presence in these areas are also hostile to the U.S.
If the bad guys can do it to Israel as a democracy and can turn us into demons and apartheid and fascists and you name it, basically they can do it to every democracy, United States included.
President Obama makes his first presidential visit to Israel in March, and discussions over the future of Judea and Samaria are sure to be on his agenda with Prime Minister Netanyahu.
Coming up, now even the IRS is targeting supporters of Judea and Samaria. More on that after the break.
When you're driving along and your cell phone rings, do your eyes instantly go off the road? Then you need to get a grip. Hi, David Jones here with the new GripGo, the most versatile hands-free mount that will instantly grip any phone for safe driving. Just attach the suction cup to your windshield or dash, and GripGo grabs your phone ultra fast. That it peels right off. And don't worry, there's no sticky residue left behind. The 360-degree pivoting mount allows you to always get the perfect viewing angle. It's even strong enough to grab and hold this expensive smartphone out the window, yet it comes right off with ease. That's the advantage of GripGo. You can get the amazing GripGo with dashboard mount for only $14.95. We'll send you a second kit free. Just pay separate processing and handling. Get two complete GripGo systems for just $14.95.
To order GripGo for $14.95 plus processing and handling, call 1-800-709-5259 or order online at getgripgo.com.
Jim is 38, mortgage, married, three great kids. He wants to protect his family with a $500,000 term life insurance policy. What do you think it'll cost him? $100 a month? $60? $40? Actually, none of the above. Jim can get a $500,000 policy from a highly rated insurer for under $19 a month. His secret? SelectQuote. SelectQuote is impartial. They'll comparison shop the pick of insurance companies like these to give you a choice of your best prices. SelectQuote has great savings on term life for women, too. Jim's wife, Deidre, can get a $500,000 policy for under $16 a month. SelectQuote has helped make term life insurance affordable for hundreds of thousands of people since 1985. How about you? Just call this number or go to SelectQuote.com. SelectQuote. We shop. You save.
Welcome back. You know, amid all the controversy over the Obama IRS shamelessly targeting conservative groups, one important nugget was largely overlooked. The IRS also went after pro-Israel groups, in particular groups that oppose Obama administration policies on Judea and Samaria. One of the groups was Hayovel, which is a very good friend of this show. It seems the whole world is gathered against Israel, doesn't it? Even the U.S. government can no longer be considered a friend. But the people of Gush Etzion have the right attitude.
We always live with this, but we believe it should be strong. We should show them that we are going to stay here and we're happy to live in a peace with people that want to live in a peace.
The Bible says one day the lion will lay down with the lamb and the Arab will embrace the Jew. Isaiah describes a highway running from Syria through Israel and into Egypt. Before we get there, I'm not going to lie to you, it's going to be tough. But God is with Israel, and God is with those who love and fear Him. So I encourage you to take a stand with Israel, for Jerusalem, for Judea and Samaria, for all of Israel, and never hold your peace. God bless you, and I'll see you next week.